I'm just going to read an email we've had from Yvonne, who says, my soon-to-be 80-year-old mother has driven from Bisley in West Yorkshire to be at the flypast in Sheffield. She set out at 5 o'clock this morning. It would have been her wedding anniversary to my late father, who was in the RAF and a civilian aero engineer. She was determined to show her support because she's been so touched by the whole story. I don't know exactly where she is, but if anyone knows where Yvonne's mum is in the crowd, thank you. So yeah, I know it's going to be a hard task, isn't it, to be all here. But thank you so much. There are so many stories like this as well this morning. You know, it's really touched people because this sense of what happened here, and just to imagine it as well, you know, 75 years ago today, there was a plane with 10 US airmen on who were travelling back to their base. And unfortunately, they struggled. There was problems with the weather. And when the pilot was coming in to find where he could land, he saw this green area, but then he saw that there were children playing here. One of those children was Tony. He was just 8 at the time. He was playing here. And the pilot thought that he didn't want to hurt the children and ended up crashing the plane into the wooded area over there, where there is now a memorial. And as you know, the whole reason we're here is because of Tony's dedication to that memorial, looking after it. And as he says, they're his family, they're his friends. He feels that he owes his life to them. And so the mixed emotions of celebrating this whilst mourning their loss, you know, it's really, really powerful. And as I say, loads of people here celebrating. We've got some wonderful vehicles around us. We've got a fantastic US Air Force. And we've got Charlie State amongst the crowd somewhere. Charlie, where are you?
Thank you.